So first thing about pancreatic cancer is it's probably the most devastating form of cancer that you can get. So while it's diagnosed in a relatively small population, so there's maybe 5,000 people across Canada that get diagnosed with pancreatic cancer every year, almost 95% of those patients die within 6 months of being diagnosed. We study the genes that are involved in pancreatic cancer and how they're linked to either susceptibility for pancreatic cancer or also for other diseases that are associated with the pancreas, like pancreatitis. And so one gene that we were working on is a gene called ATRX. So we developed a model, a preclinical model, in which we tried to see if getting rid of this gene affected progression or susceptibility to pancreatic cancer. And so the first thing that we found was that it did. If you got rid of this gene, you end up getting much more progressive pancreatic cancer. You end up getting much more pancreatic damage that you see in the disease called pancreatitis. But what was really interesting is it was only in female mice. This is the very first time that we've had a gene that gives susceptibility in that sex-specific way. The biggest problem with pancreatic cancer is that it's diagnosed so late. And that because it's diagnosed so late, all of a sudden when you try to treat it, people aren't responding to the therapies that are available. So this gives an opportunity to look at a different type of therapy. But it also gives an opportunity for maybe this is an early marker for detecting pancreatic cancer. Because what we think is going on is that this mutation that's occurred is really just laying the groundwork for other factors that would promote pancreatic cancer to take hold.